वेलकम टू मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाजस के आरटी आर्ट्स बीएच कॉमर्स एम साइंस के टीचम कॉलेज नासिक। मायसेल्फ संपा डेमसे वर्किंग एज असोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक साइंस। डियर स्टूडेंट, वी स्टार्टेड यूनिट टू इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट एंड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी सॉ द अरिथमेटिक इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट, data transfer instruction set part 1, part 2, part 3. Today's video lecture we are going to discuss data transfer instruction set part 4. Every instruction consists of three fields: operation code field, operand of address of operand 1, address of operand 2. An instruction is made up of operation code followed by operands, and the operands can be one of those data to be operated on, CPU register, memory location, or an input output. Depending upon operation they perform, all the instructions are divided into five groups. Instruction set. First group is data transfer instruction, arithmetic instruction, logical instruction, bit oriented instruction, and branch instruction. So these are the five types of instruction. We saw in previous video lecture that is arithmetic instructions. In today's video lecture we are going to discuss our data transfers instructions, and those are like this. Data transfer instructions are associated with transfer the data between register or external memory, program memory or external data memory. The mnemonics associated with this data transfer instruction is like this. More already we discussed. So in today's video lecture we are going to discuss exchange, XCH. Exchange, XCHD, and push and pop. So here the following table lists out all the possible data transfers along with their details like addressing mode, size occupied, number of machine cycles it takes. So these are the tables showing these four instruction only. So this table consists of a mnemonics, instruction description, addressing mode, number of bytes required to execute that instruction. First instruction is push direct. Whatever the direct byte content, that will be stored on stack pointed by stack pointer register. Stack pointer register update. This is having direct addressing mode, 2 byte required to store this instruction or execute this instruction, 2 machine cycle required. So this is the insertion operation take place when the push direct instruction executed. When pop direct, so this retrieving the data from stack to the specified direct address. So the content of direct address will be the content of stack pointed by stack pointer register. So retrieving data using pop instruction. So this is the next instruction, that is XCH RN. Here the exchange, the RN means general purpose register, with the accumulator. So this is the exchange accumulator with RN register. RN may be general purpose register R0 to R7. Register addressing, 1 byte instruction, 1 machine cycle required. XCH direct, exchange accumulator with a direct byte, and this is a direct addressing instruction, 2 bytes instruction, one for operation code and one for direct byte. This is need one machine cycle to execute. XCH at the rate RI, indirect, the content of random access memory pointed by general purpose register RI, RI may be R0 or R1. So exchange accumulator content with indirect random access memory, and the address of random access memory given by indirectly RI register. So this is an indirect addressing instruction. One machine cycle required to execute this, and one byte instruction. The next one is XCHD A comma at the rate RI. Here the exchange the accumulator with lower byte indirect random access memory. So this is a lower order nibble data will be exchanged with accumulator lower order data, and that is why this is the only nibble, means 4 bit lower random access memory content, and the content of accumulator lower nibble get exchanged. Upper nibble remains as it is. So this is the indirect addressing instruction. One byte required to store this instruction, and this is the one machine cycle required to execute this. Let us see the instructions in details. XCHA A comma RN, exchange RN, that is general purpose register, with accumulator. Description: this instruction calls the accumulator and RN register to exchange the data. The exchange of data between accumulator and RN register. The content of accumulator is moved to the content to the RN register, and vice versa. RN register also data move in accumulator. So this is the exchange instruction. XCH A comma RN. RN may be R0 to R7. Addressing mode, register addressing mode. One byte instruction. Now this instruction having mnemonics like this. Suppose XCH A comma R3, the content of R3 register, general purpose register, exchange with accumulator. So accumulator content goes in R3, R3 content goes in accumulator. Having the operation code CB H and one byte instruction, one machine cycle, no flags are affected. So before execution, if you see the 4K memory, program memory having the operation code, that is CB at memory location address 000H, and the content of program counter now 0001H, and that is the content of program counter register, that instruction get executed. Now the selection of R3 register is like this. Program status word register having the content RS0 and RS1 having 00. So this 00 indicates the bank 0 address, and this bank 0 having R0 to R7 register, and we use R3, means that R3 having 29H content, and the content of accumulator suppose CFH. Now this R3 register content and CF content get exchanged with each other. So after execution of this instruction, if you observe, the content of accumulator now becomes 29H, and the content of R3 register, whose address is given by this bank 0, so that content get exchanged. Now this becomes CF, that is content of accumulator, and 29H will be goes in accumulator. So this is the exchange instruction take place. So content of, now this is the exchange instruction A comma at the rate RI, exchange indirect random access memory with accumulator. The content of RI, that this register is R0 or R1. So R0 and R1 always give the address of random access memory indirectly. Description: this instruction moves the content of accumulator to indirect addressing register of random access memory and vice versa. As it is indirect addressing instruction, the register address is stored in register R0 and R1. Okay, so this RI is always R0 or R1. Next one is addressing mode, indirect addressing, 1 byte instruction. The status flags are not affected. So syntax will be like this here: XCH A comma at the rate RI. The mnemonics will be like this: XCH A comma at the rate R0. So this gives us the address of random access memory, that content and accumulator content get exchanged. This instruction having the operation code C8H. Okay, so C8H is the instruction having the address operation code. So it is stored in program memory. This is a 2 byte instruction, means 000H C8H and 001H, that is at the rate R0 address of R0 register, which gives the address of random access memory indirectly. So the program counter register now becomes, this is instead of 001, it is 002, that is the content of program counter. So this instruction get executed. Now here the content of accumulator is 1AH and the content of a memory, so that is pointed by R0, okay, indirectly, that is 78H. That content is 68H. That and accumulator content exchange. So here the content of accumulator and the content of random access memory whose address is pointed by R0, that is 78H, that content is 68H, get exchanged with each other after execution. So if you observe this memory content whose address is 78H pointed by R0 register, that content goes in accumulator, and the content of accumulator now goes in where the random access memory whose address is pointed by R0 register. So this is the 1AH. So after execution, the content of accumulator and content of random access memory exchange with each other. Okay, so this is the exchange instruction. Exchange A comma direct. Direct byte with accumulator. Exchange the direct byte with accumulator. The direct byte register may be addressed from 0 to 255 in decimal and in hexadecimal 0 to FFH. A indicates accumulator. Description of this instruction: the instruction moves the content of accumulator to the direct byte and vice versa. It is the direct addressing instruction. The direct byte can be any special function register or general purpose register with address 0 to 7FH or in hexadecimal, this is in hexadecimal, and in decimal 0 to 127 decimal. This instruction having the mnemonics XCH A comma direct. This is a 2 byte instruction, 1 byte for operation code and another byte is for direct byte address. The status registers, no flags are affected. The addressing mode is a direct. This instruction having mnemonics like this: XCH A comma 78H, and its operation code is C5H. 2 byte instruction, 2 machine cycle required. Flags are not affected. So before execution, if you see program memory to execute this instruction, program memory needs to addresses, one for operation code, another for the address of random access memory directly pointed by direct byte. The new content of program counter, that is the address 000 to 16 bit, and this address instruction will get executed after execution of this instruction. So this instruction having before execution having the data like this. So here in program, that is the random access memory data memory 128, the address is 78H having the content 5BH, and this content and accumulator content exchange with each other. So the content of accumulator is 90H, content of random access memory whose address is 78H having the content 5B, they get exchange with each other. Okay, so it is like this. So after execution, you will observe that the content of accumulator 90H goes in random access memory whose content is 78H, that is having 90H content. So the accumulator will be 5BH. So the content of this 5B random access memory move in accumulator or exchange with accumulator. So this is the execution of this instruction. Now we are having the next instruction XCHD A comma at the rate RI. Now this is the instruction exchange lower byte nibble indirect to random access memory with the accumulator. So the content of accumulator lower byte, lower nibble, and the content of random access memory whose address is pointed by RI, that lower nibble exchange with accumulator. RI may be R0 or R1, and A is accumulator. The description of this instruction interchange, exchange the lower byte nibble means 4 bit 0 to 3 of accumulator with lower order nibble of the indirectly address register of random access memory. The higher nibble of accumulator and register, that is random access memory, are not affected, that remains as it is. This instruction is mainly used when the operating with BCD binary coded decimal values, as it indirect addressing the address, indirect addressing the register, the address is stored in a register that is given by RI 0 or 1. This instruction is having the mode, that is register indirect. This status register, no flags are affected. So this is 1 byte instruction having the syntax XCHD A comma at the rate RI. This is the mnemonics, that is XCHD A comma at R0. So this RI means R0 or R1. So R0, and having the operation code, if it is R0 then D6, 2 byte instruction, 1 machine cycle, no flags affected. And if we write here 1, then operation code is D7, then 2 byte instruction, 1 machine cycle required. So before execution, so this instruction to be executed, then it should be moved in program memory 4K. So 000H is having the operation code D6, that means this first instruction get executed, exchange HD A comma at the rate R0, and R3 register. Okay, the content of this at the rate R0 will the one memory location required. The content of program counter now becomes 0002, and this instruction will be get executed after this instruction execution. Now the content of a bank, that is given by PSW register 00 means bank 0 gets selected and mean bank 0, R0 to R7 registers are there. So here the exchange of random access memory whose address is given by 57H. So this indirectly given by R0 register, and that is 57H is the content of R0. That content is 78H. So the content of random access memory whose address is indirectly pointed by R0, that is 57H, that content is 78H. This 78H and the content of accumulator 9AH get exchanged with each other. So the only lower nibble means 8 and lower nibble of accumulator is A exchange. Upper nibble will be remains as it is. 7 and 9 remains as it is. So when this instruction executed, the content of accumulator in binary format, that is 90001 and A 1010, and content of this register, that is, we are not using this R3, means we are not going to consider it. Now, after execution, the content of accumulator will be 998H. So the content of this random access memory whose address is pointed by R0, 57, and that content is 78H. So this 8 and this A, now they get exchanged after execution. So the content of accumulator now becomes the 98H, and the content of random access memory whose address is pointed by R0, 57H, that content now becomes 7AH. So this 8 and this A get exchanged after execution. So this is the exchange instruction. A swap instruction, swap the nibble within the accumulator itself, means whatever the content of accumulator, the content of accumulator gets swapped. So lower nibble becomes upper nibble and upper nibble becomes lower nibble. So a nibble refer to the group of 4 bits within the register. So this bit 0 to bit 3, this is lower nibble, and bit 4 to bit 7, that is upper nibble. This instruction interchanges high and low nibbles of accumulator. So how it is, you see here, this is the instruction swap A, 1 byte instruction. The register flags, means status registers, are not affected, and this instruction having mnemonics swap A, and this instruction having the operation code C4H, and 1 byte instruction, one machine cycle required. So before execution, suppose the content of accumulator is E1H. E in binary format will be 0001, and in 1 is in binary format 0001. So this is a binary number, this is a hexadecimal number. When the swapping is take place, when swap instruction executed, the content of lower nibble and upper nibble exchange. So after execution, the content of accumulator becomes 1EH. So the swapping of what? 1 and E take place. And in binary format, it will be 0011110. So this is a binary format content. And it is take place like this. So this is the content of lower nibble goes to upper nibble, and upper nibble goes to lower nibble. So this is your E and this is a 1. After execution, this 1 goes here and E goes here. Now let us discuss the stack instruction. Stack and stack pointer ESP, a register of 8051. The register used to access the stack is known as stack pointer register. The stack pointer register is in 8051 is 8 bit capacity, and it takes the value from 0 to FFH. Stack pointer is a small register to store stores the address of top of the stack memory, and the stack operates in last in first out sense, that is LIFO fashion. Our last data inserted is taken out first, that is LIFO or first in first out, LIFO or PILO. Okay, so this is the data stored on stack or data taken from stack. Push and pop instructions are stored, instruction data stored on stack or removed from stack. That is the insertion and deletion operation take place. Push instructions executed 8-bit data stored on stack, and the SP now becomes SP plus 1 incremented by 1. When the pop instruction executed 8-bit data taken from stack, and then SP becomes now SP minus 1 decremented by 1. Now this is the structure of stack. Suppose we are having 256 memory stack. Address is started from 00 to FF, and this stack pointer, let us suppose the X and Y values content stored in 00 and 01. So here the stack pointer always point the top address of stack memory. So here stack pointer register having 02 address, because that is it shows the top address of empty stack. So this is the stack location, empty address is shown by stack pointer register. Now after execution, it is a 8-bit register. After executions, suppose we want to execute push instruction. So the push instruction push the value onto the stack, and this is the syntax of that. So this instruction having mnemonics C2H, C0H and 2-byte instruction, flags are not affected. Push description, push the value of specified internal RAM address onto the stack. The push first increment the value of stack pointer, and then the take the value stored into the IRAM, that is memory, and store it in internal random access memory at the locations pointed by the incremented stack pointer. So suppose there is a push internal RAM address is given, that is suppose 03, and having the content Z. So this content we want to store on stack. Now here, when this instruction executed, the content of stack will be like this. If you see, this is the 02 is the address of empty stack. It is like this. And when push 03 instruction we execute, then the value of this 02 is Z, move on stack. Now the content of stack will be 02 location is having a Z, and now the stack pointer incremented by 1, that is previously it was 02 and it becomes now 03, that is shows the empty stack. So in this way the push or insertion operations take place, and stack pointer incremented by 1, and we stored whatever the random access memory data, that Z data, on stack memory. So this is the push operation. Next one is pop operation. We name it as a deletion operation. When the pop instruction executed, then pop the value from stack having the operation code D0H, 2-byte instruction, and pop IRAM address. Now the content of stack will now move on random access memory whose address is pointed by IRAM address byte. Pop the last value placed on stack into the random access, internal random access memory address specified. In other word, pop will load the IRAM, that is internal RAM address, with the value of internal RAM address pointed by the current stack pointer. The current stack pointer is decremented by 1. Now if you see, when we execute, suppose the pop IRAM address, and we assume that address is having, that is 0-2 address having Z data. So here if you observe, this is a stack, and this Z data we want to remove from the stack, whose address is 0-2. So this is the address location, means stack location address, and stack pointer always gives the top address of stack, empty stack. So this will be 00000203 is the address of stack pointer, current address. So when this instruction executed, our stack pointer decrement by 1 first, and when it is decrement, then it will be 02. So if you observe, this is a pop 02. So the content of random access memory 02 will be nothing but the content of stack pointer. So stack pointer content will be decremented by 1, 0-2. So whatever the data here, so that is removed, that data goes in this memory locations whose address is 0-2H. So we are in deleting the stack content, or that is the deletion operation when pop is executed. Pop the content of stack to the address that is 0-2. Now this stack pointer decremented by 2. So this is the address of top address of stack that is given by stack pointer register. Okay, so here what we discuss in this video lecture, we saw the exchange instruction, we saw the stack related instruction. Exchange instruction is XCHD, and we saw the push and pop instruction, what is stack, stack pointer, register in detail. I hope you may understand this video lecture. Thank you for listening and watching this video. If you have any difficulty regarding with this topic, please contact me on my mail address sampardmc57@gmail.com. My WhatsApp number is 9860389302. Thank you, students, for watching this video.